general safety rules before we get started with the specific machinery. First thing, always have safety glasses on. Second, you have to wear closed-toed shoes when you're in the shop. Third, if you have long hair, you need to make sure your long hair is tied back. Fourth, secure any loose clothing and take any jewelry off that you have on. Fifth, if you have long sleeves, when you're operating machines, you want to make sure those are pushed up to your elbows. And the last one, whenever you're operating a machine, you do not want to wear gloves, because gloves can get caught up in the moving parts. Okay, before we can drill our metal, we have to prepare our metal for drilling. And the steps in doing that is you need to lay out where you want to drill. So you can see I've marked my metal where I want to drill. And before we can drill that, we need to center punch our metal. And what center punching means is you take a tool called the center punch, and it's angled here, and this is made out of metal as well. And what this is going to do is it's going to put a small indentation into our metal right where we want to drill. And that makes it so that the drill bit can enter the metal precisely where we want to have the hole drilled. If we don't do this step, you can break your drill bit and your hole is not going to be drilled in the spot where you need it to be drilled. So before we get started, we always want to lay out where we want to drill, take a center punch, line the tip of the center punch right on center of your marking where you want to drill. You grab your hammer and one good hit, and that's our center punch. Okay, so now we're looking at the drill press and how to use this machine safely. We have two drill presses in our metal shop. We have one here and the other one is located right behind here. So these are our drilling stations. Remember that you're only going to operate the machine one person at a time. And when we do this, we need to follow all the general safety rules that we described earlier. We've already center punched our metal, but first we need to secure the drill bit into the chuck on our drill press. We're using a 1/4-inch drill bit, and on the end of the drill bit, where there are no flutes, it's called the shank. That is what we need to secure into the drill press. This is our chuck. If you turn it to the left, these three jaws in here open up. If you turn it to the right, they tighten down. So you want to place the shank of the drill bit into the chuck and tighten that by hand. After you have it tightened by hand, you want to grab your chuck key and you want to make sure that you tighten all three holes on the chuck. We tighten all three holes to make sure that the chuck has even pressure on the drill bit and so that the drill bit is secure in the chuck and it won't come loose while we're drilling. After you tighten all three holes on the chuck, you want to make sure that you always remove the chuck key. If you leave this chuck key in here and you turn the drill press on, this chuck key is going to get thrown across the room at a high rate of speed, causing danger and possibly hurting somebody. So after you tighten all three holes, always remove the chuck key. Now we have our metal that I've already center punched. We want to make sure that we always secure our metal before we drill that. We have a drill press vise here, and this works well because it's going to hold our metal, and then it's going to give us something large to hold on to keep that metal secure. If I were to just try drilling this without having it clamped down or in the vise, it's going to tear my hand up and I'm going to get hurt. So we always want to make sure that we clamp our metal into the drill press vise. If it's too large to fit into the drill press vise, we make sure that we have C clamps and we can clamp it right to the table. So we're going to place this into our drill press vise. Make sure it's nice and tight. And before we drill, we need to make sure that our drill bit, the tip of our drill bit, is lined up with where we center punched. And what I always do before I drill is I make sure I mounted that drill bit in the chuck correctly. So before I do any drilling, I turn this on and I make sure that that drill is going nice and straight and there's no wobble. If there's any wobble, I mounted it in the chuck incorrectly and I need to remount that drill bit. But that was nice and straight, so that's ready to go. Before I can drill, I want to make sure I don't have it turned on, and I line the tip of that drill bit right in to where we center punched. So I line that up right with our center punch. Now I'm ready to go. Turn my machine on. One hand on the handle, the other on the on the drill press vise to hold it steady, and we want to slowly work our way through our metal. Remember, the larger the hole, the slower you're going to go, and I usually breathe the drill bit by just letting up pressure for a second, and that makes sure that any material that's caught up is relieved. And as I feel that drill bit about to break through the back side of the metal, I ease up on my pressure and I go through the back side of that metal nice and slowly. That prevents that material from getting seized, and it makes a nice clean exit out of the back of the metal. When you're done, bring this up slowly. Don't just let it fling back up. And then when we're done, we turn the machine off. If you do come into a circumstance where your material does get seized by the drill bit, and the drill bit is grabbed on your material and it's turning, if you have it clamped in the drill press vise, the good thing about this is it's only going to be able to turn to here. At that point, what usually would happen is your drill bit would break, and then it's spinning freely. We got a broken drill bit, the material is here. If it does get seized, we want to make sure that we step back, turn the machine off. After everything stops, then we address the situation. Don't panic if that happens and try to do something while the machine is running. Turn the machine off. If it's safe, if nothing's flying around here and you can safely turn this off, which you should be able to do, turn the machine off, wait till it stops, come and get me, and we'll take care of it. Okay, a couple other adjustments that we might need to, that you may need to make on the drill press. First is adjusting the depth. We can set our depth stop at a depth to where that spindle will stop. Right now it's here, but what we can do is line it up with where, when we have our drill bit mounted in here, where we want that to stop. We can set the depth stop in that position, and then it would stop where we need that to stop. This is something that we don't always have to use when we're using a drill press, but if we're in an application where we do need to stop a hole at a certain depth, we can use our depth stop. If we need to adjust the table, when we do that, we need to loosen this clamp here, and then this can turn this up and down. Make sure you keep a hold on the table just to keep it lined up. And then after you get it set where you need it, make sure you clamp this back down so it's nice and tight. If you leave it loose and you go to drill, it can move while you're drilling and you can break your drill bit, cause damage to your project or to yourself. And the last thing is, when we're done with the drill press, we want to make sure we clean our area up. We always want to put the drill press vise back down underneath here and clean the area so it's ready for the next student to use.